nervous about investing out of state and having a property management team take care of everything. So what do you look for when picking a property management company? And how do you trust them if you're not available to physically check in on things? Thanks.
Thank you, Molly. So this is one of the biggest and the most important questions about becoming a real estate investor. You know, you're creating a team. You want to have a team around you. You do not live in a vacuum. You know, you are not an island. You have to have a great team around you. And the way that I am able to operate our rental properties is with a great property management team. So that's very important. Like when our team at Morris Invest, like when we're vetting property management companies, number one, and by the way, I have a whole video on what we look for in a property management team. I would check that video out. We'll link it in the description below, as well as we have an interview with our property management team. So you can see the process they go through. We walk through the office. You can see the screening process for tenants, all of that. So I would encourage you to check out that video. We'll have a link in the description for you to check that out. A couple of things. Number one, we want to make sure that they have been in business for at least 5 years, that they use great software, up-to-date standards rental software, you know, whether it's AppFolio or there's a couple different ones, but you know, those are the top of the line ones. How do they screen their tenants? What kinds of criminal background checks and all of that do they do on the tenants? How do they place the tenants? What types of lease agreements are in place? How regularly are they communicating with the tenants? All of those things, incredibly important. Do they have a great relationship with the tenants? You know, when in our walkthrough video of our property management's office, you can see tenants in there, and we even pulled some tenants aside and interviewed them. And like, oh, we love working with them. So the tenants like the property management team. That's incredibly important. They don't have like an adversarial relationship. Bottom line is, I don't ever want to have to deal with tenants and toilets. I don't ever want to have a phone call from a tenant. I don't want my iPhone ringing because a tenant has an issue. No, there should be a team, a property management team in place that can handle a faucet that's leaking or some issue, right? They'll handle that through their maintenance department. They will make sure that the tenant is getting ready for their lease renewal. Hey, your lease is coming up in a month and a half. Are you considering staying in the property? We'll extend the same rental rate, et cetera. All of those discussions are taking place ahead of time. Are they proactive? So with a property management team, you shouldn't have to worry about any of that. And that's why when people say to me, wow, I can't imagine owning rental properties out of state. Well, how do I handle that? What do I do? Well, the answer is you don't do anything. You hire a great property management team that handles everything. Now, I've got properties all over the United States. I don't ever see them. Almost all of them, I've never even set foot in. I've never seen the property. I have a great team that takes care of making sure that those properties run flawlessly. And that's how you run a business. You know, if you want to be in the business of property management, then that's a whole second job for yourself. You know, you want to set up software and do all that and spreadsheets and be on the phone with the tenant and checking in on them to make sure they're paying rent on time and all of those things. That's a full-time job. So I'm happy to pay a property management company a percentage of the rent every month, whether it's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10% of the rent. It varies depending on what state and so forth, but I'm more than happy to make that commitment to a property management team. And by the way, that number that I'm paying a property management team is figured into my return on investment number, you know, into my internal rate of return number. Like all of those numbers are in my spreadsheet. So this is not just like an added expense on top. I've already thought about it. I've already plotted everything out, and it's still a fantastic investment, even with me paying a property management company to manage it all. It's an expense for my business, and a very valuable expense, one I'm very, very happy to pay. So thank you, Molly, for that question. If you'd like to ask us a question, you can just go to Morris Invest, our website, morrisinvest.com, and leave us a voicemail question. We'll be happy to answer it for you. So thank you so much for your kind words and your time today. And go out there, take action, become a real estate investor. I believe it's the number one way to create wealth and to preserve wealth. We'll see you next time.